Okay? So for this reason, no. And here they obscurely say speedy ship LLC is a nominal consignee who does not have a right to make an entry. So that's it. Yeah? This is a good question. I think this is a good question because it covers a lot of things. Notice, yes, because speedy ship LLC gave the broker power of attorney and they have a continuous bond on file with CBP. Well, you can't do that because you are nominal consignee. This is not good enough. Look at this one. Speedy Ship LLC hired the broker, but the broker must be authorized broker, and the broker must do the proper job, right? You cannot have a even if you hire a broker, it is assumed that the broker knows what it's doing. The broker was never supposed to put importer of record, Speedy Ship LLC, as importer of record. So this is not correct. Yes, because Speedy Ship LLC is express consignment operator and gave the broker power of attorney and they have a continuous bond to file. Well, that doesn't make any sense. Because consignment operators, unless they are licensed, cannot do that. Broker, even though the proper, must put its own name as an importer of record. So what the question comes down to is, if you have a nominal consignee, such as express consignment operator, freight consolidator, and you go to the licensed customs broker, who can, what should a licensed customs broker for Speedy Ship LLC done? Who should be the importer of record for the shipment? The licensed customs broker. And licensed customs broker bond must be on it. So if you have a nominal consignee knocking on your door saying, can you clear the entry? You say yes, but when you say yes, that means you are legally responsible all the way. All the way meaning you can, of course, make sure that you can file a superseding bond and make sure that the actual, the real owner, right, has it. But until then, you have to be legally responsible for the duties, you have to be legally responsible for the custody, you have to be legally responsible for the bond, for filing proper documents, anything that goes with it. That's the point of this exercise. So nominal consignee can go to the licensed customs broker. The licensed customs broker has to be authorized, meaning they have to have a license, power of attorney, and permit, plus they must be acting as importer of record. All that is a heavy burden of licensed customs broker, LCB. Yeah? Make sense? Moving on? Any questions?
A quick one.
Yeah.
The nominal consignee, they wouldn't have the filer code, right?
Filer code?
No, they don't.
Nominal consignee? So the question is this. Whenever you make an entry, you know, like usually the companies, they get assigned their own numbers. So every entry gets assigned their number. And it's composed of 731. It is composed of this many digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 digits, right? And each of those digits, they have a name. So the question is, this digit is, this first three digits identify usually the party. And it usually is a licensed customs broker. And this first digit are colloquially called, we shall explore it later, as a filer code. So the question is, can this filer code be assigned to nominal cosignee? But then we know that nominal cosignee in this situation does not have a right to make entry in the first place. It is the licensed customs broker who would have that filer code assigned, would put his filer code, his or her filer code, on the entry document to submit to customs. So that means that nominal cosignee, unless that nominal cosignee is licensed customs broker, would not be acting as an importer of record. That's it. If the licensed customs broker is proper nominal cosignee who can make an entry under that exception, then no problem. They can use a filer code, their filer code. They have to use their filer code. There's no other way. It's their burden. Burden of the LCB. Moving on. Okay, let's take a look at one more. Jack Spratt import. So here, this is easy one because there is not much in the facts. You can still start with the question, which is, which of the following is appropriate entry for entry processing procedure? And it may look like a question on the entry procedure, but it's misleading. So you go through the answer choices and you see that really it is kind of about the procedure, but it's really about who can do that. Who is this, the right party? Can that party come in and file a document, or should customs never see his food in the customs house? So in the customs office. So the question really goes on what can the Jack Spratt imports do. So Jack Spratt imports, customs tell us, is a nominal cosignee, desires to generate an entry for the shipment. All right, that's all we know. No parentheses. So we know Jack Spratt imports can be a nominal cosignee who can generate an entry for a shipment as long as Jack Spratt imports is one, licensed, two, did I erase this? Is listed as importer of record and has power of attorney and has permit. In other words, Jack Spratt imports is authorized. So here, this is the type of question you really have to engage in a process of elimination. It's the best way to do it. Unless this very same question will show up on the exam and you just remember it. Because sometimes you may be lucky, customs sometimes just copies and pastes the previous questions to the present exam and you just, wow, I've seen this before. This way, then you can save yourself a bunch of time, just check this and move on. Maybe check this later. But also watch out because they may change a little wording to trick you up. So always be very careful with this. But let's take a look. Jack Spratt imports can file an entry as a nominal cosignee. Well, here's a good example of the best answer rule. Best answer rule means that you have to really look at the facts. Given the facts, it is possible that they can file entry as a nominal cosignee, but they also have to be authorized licensed customs broker. Based on this information, you do not have that information, so it is possible. So I would kind of check A, but I would not really bank on it because there may be the better answer because it's not as complete. So A, I would say, is a check minus. Then B, Jack Spratt imports can file an entry as a nominal cosignee for the importer of record. When would that be true? When Jack Spratt imports, again, is a licensed customs broker who is authorized, meaning they have power of attorney and they have district permit. none of that is given. So it is possible, but we simply, the customs examiners do not give us enough information. Next, Jack Sprat Imports can have a broker file an entry for them through listing Jack Sprat Imports as importer of record. Do you remember that Speedy LLC example? It had the same situation. You can, if Jack Sprat Imports is not an importer of, is not a licensed customs broker, he cannot be listed as an importer of record, period. But if that Jack Sprat Imports is a licensed customs broker, why would he need to go and pay extra money to the another broker? Maybe that, here I'm going off the tangent, because it is possible, because maybe I'm too busy. It's less expensive for me to hire I'm a licensed customs broker, but you know what? I have classes to teach. I don't have time for this. And my name is Jack Sprat Imports. So I'm gonna call up another licensed customs broker who has more time, and I'm gonna say, you know what? I'll pay you money. Can you do this for me? But then the situation would be, who can be listed as importer of record? And this is, then this gets weird, because technically both of us can be listed. So, but this is imagination to the second or third degree. And when you get to the second degree, watch out. Watch out, I would put two minuses here. Because there's just too much imagination you have to engage in to make this true answer. D, Jack Sprat Imports can file an entry as the importer of record. Well, yes, if they are licensed customs broker and they're authorized. So A, B, D is just as good as A and B. E, Jack Sprat Imports can have a broker file an entry for them if the broker is listed on the importer record. So look at the fact pattern. So Jack Sprat Imports can have one, a broker filing. So presumably broker, licensed customs broker, LCB. We only know B part. We do not know if they are licensed. Are they authorized? We don't know. If the broker is listed on the importer of record, so E, licensed customs broker, must be importer of record, IOR. Let's check. You still are not sure. This is true, right? You still are not sure if the broker is authorized. But this is a better answer, simply because when you engage in analysis of, we know that we have a bunch of minuses here. Here, we have can file entries on nominal consignee, provided that they have they are licensed customs broker. So question one. And provided that the licensed customs broker is authorized, question two. Here, file an entry as nominal consignee for the importer of record, provided that the Jack Sprat Imports is a licensed customs broker, which we don't know, and Jack Sprat Imports an entry as a nominal consignee. And this contradicts here, because Jack Sprat import for the importer of record. Well, this is odd, because we know that we know from the above that only licensed customs broker must be the importer of record. Here we do not know that. So given that the Jack Sprat Imports is a nominal consignee, is it a licensed customs broker? And only then, if it's a licensed customs broker, it can. So you have to pass, is it licensed customs broker? Yes. And only then you have to ask, can it be the importer of record? So notice, the levels of obscurity, D, B, and A, this is outlier, right? But A, B, and D, level of obscurity is much higher than for E. Because here you have kind of legal truth. It is true that you can have importer, you can have broker file and entry. But customs examiners don't tell you if it's a licensed customs broker who is authorized. That's why, well, that's what makes it so difficult. So this is a question which should get you in the mood of being accustomed to answering, to playing this game. Because at the end of the day, what's going to matter is whether you got this answer correctly or not. And understanding the level of obscurity, which this is pretty high, in my opinion. Understanding the level of obscurity is very important for you to develop a feel of how this will go. So whenever you, starting today, you have practice questions. And whenever you ask, look at, try to analyze those questions, please pay attention to the level of ambiguity or level of obscurity the customs uses. Because in this question, the level of obscurity is much lower because they actually list, they in the fact pattern, they give kind of a good clue of what is authorized licensed customs broker and what is not. Here, they do not do that. And I'm not changing, I'm just copying and pasting it from the previous customs exams. So this is kind of like both these two questions present an opposite ends of each other. And the best way to do that is, again, even though we're dealing with the level of obscurity, there is still check minus. If there is more obscure, I would put more minuses, right? If it's check, more or less okay, I would just leave it that. If it's this one, I would put check plus. And then I just balance the number of relevant factors. Here we have two. This is true, and this is true. So I will have two pluses here. Here, in C, for example, I will have several minuses. One minus is this one. So this is a minus here. A broker. We do not know if it's authorized broker. Listing, Jack Sprat imports, import to rare. That's minus. That's another minus. You cannot have that. You can have this. You can have broker, but not Jack Sprat imports.